I want to tell you about a man I once knew. He lived in a land so beautiful and white and silent that if you scraped a harpoon on the ice, you could hear it for miles and miles.
We give thanks for what the earth provides. My people, the Inuit, have lived here for thousands of years. But the land my forefathers knew is disappearing. We can see the changes happening before our very eyes.
They told him of a dream passed down by the elders. It would change his life and mine. He lived his whole life under a big, open sky, hunting and fishing in the wilderness. But he found himself in an unknown world. So he left his homeland at the top of the earth, and he came to the south, where the rest of us live.
Where is the silence? All these people, all this noise, it's getting closer and closer, and I'm getting smaller and smaller. I must see the sky above me in order to feel the ground beneath me. But here, with all this, it is difficult to feel anything.
My parents call me Catherine, but on the streets, I go by Chloe. And for me, that morning was just like any other. Except for one thing. A freaking Eskimo?
Yo, my man.
Hello.
You lost?
Lost. Can't find your way home.
Do you speak English? Speak English. Good.
All right, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take you to wherever you gotta go, you feel me?
I need to speak to your elders.
You wanna speak to my mama?
I have an important message.
But listen here. So you can talk to my moms, right? That's cool. But you gotta pay me. All right? Dinero. Money. You understand that?
Yes? Good.
But you don't understand.
Nah, homie, see, baby?
You don't understand. I understand. I understand you getting robbed, man.
Now give me your freaking money.
No money. What'd I tell you, man? You all right? What are you doing? Can't you see he's a freaking bum?
No, because he was.
What?
He would just look like a flipping tourist. He was like this and stuff, looking up the sky.
What's so good about looking down anyways? Would a tourist be dressed like a freaking Eskimo? No, he would not. Now why don't you go on and find a yo-yo with some real dough? Go on!
Dude.
Get out! Go on! You all right? You okay?
Yes.
Thanks to her. Yes, I think so.
That routine's gotta do
that. And that's when she agreed to be my guide. For a small payment, she said she would lead me to the altar.
I gotta start miming. In here are all the old people you'll ever want to meet.
These are your elders?
Not mine. But they'll do for your age fetish, I think. So here's what we'll do. I'll create a distraction.
I don't understand.
And you run in and talk to all the elders you want.
They look like prisoners.
Now pay attention. Once I've taken out the first one, I'll signal to you to go, go, go! And that'll be your chance. And you'll explode into the common room, and I'll block the door behind you. On three. One, two, three! Abandon the plan!
Hey! Hey! Hey!
Oh, man, I'm gonna ache tomorrow.
Those weren't the right elders.
How did you get here?
I walked.
Look, you wanted to see old folks, and I showed you old folks.
Is that what happens to people here when they get old? In the city, life is very unfamiliar to me, but this interesting one. I hope she can help me make my way in this strange wilderness.
This is it. Close the hatch when you come down.
Tyler. Tyler. Lights.
We agreed. It's just the three of us.
Relax, Sancho. This is Teddy.
Theo.
He's an Eskimo.
Inuk.
On a mission to see old people.
Oh, good. We agree it's just the three of us, and you bring home a grandpa journeyman.
He ripped off a mime today and gave us 38 bucks.
You know how I feel about thieves.
Yeah, you can't trust them.
Can't trust them.
Yep, well, he didn't know he was doing it at the time, so that makes it okay.
I'm not getting involved.
With what?
With anything. I know how your mind works, Chloe.
We're married, you know.
No, we're not.
We're getting married.
No.
She's my girlfriend.
Tyler!
She's my friend.
Let me show you your room. Voila!
This is my room?
Yep.
But I have
Not another word. Tonight, you are my guest. So make yourself at home.
Unbelievable.
And this is my room.
And who is this?
Where you been living? The North Pole?
Close.
Really? Huh. This is Bruce Lee. The Great One. The Master. The Dragon.
He's dead.
Or is he?
6 feet under, Chloe.
Shut up!
Was he a warrior?
The greatest. He was like, I don't know, who's your greatest warrior?
We don't have wars.
You don't have wars? What kind of people are you? Who's like the baddest hunter there's ever been in the North Pole?
Nanook.
Nanook! He's like Nanook times 1,000.
Nanook is Lord of the North.
And Bruce is the Lord of everything else. Here endeth the lesson. Sancho, what day is it?
Tuesday.
Mondays, we eat Thai food. Wednesdays, Chinese. Thursdays, Indian. And Tuesdays, Italian.
Hey, here he comes.
Pizza.
Thanks.
Food on your face.
Got it.
Are you sure you don't want any?
Really good.
So what's the deal with the old people, huh?
It's a long story.
Is it a love story?
No.
Kung Fu, yeah?
I don't think so.
Well, tell it anyway. It's not like there's much on TV.
Okay. Imagine a land so vast and beautiful and silent that if you take a harpoon, scrape the ice with it, you can hear the sound for miles and miles.
He talked about the oneness his people have with the earth. How they watch the moon to determine when the animals migrate. That history isn't written, but is passed down verbally from generation to generation. And then he told us about the Elder's Dream, the legend of the angry sun.
They told me he saw the beginning of things. They told me how we lived on the never-ending ice under the midnight sun. They told me he saw the men of the South, their capacity for destruction. Their need for expansion. Building structures that scrape the clouds and stop the sun from seeing the earth, from seeing the plants, from seeing the people. And the men of the South grew sick and ugly. But still, the refuse of their ambitions spilled out. Boiling the oceans and spreading across the great tundra itself. And then the sun grew angry.
Let me take this from the top. Your name is Teddy.
Theo.
And you are an Eskimo.
Inuk.
From Antarctica?
The Arctic. North. Not south.
On a mission from God.
From my elders.
About the end of the world.
I need to speak to your elders. Your leaders. The ones who the people listen to.
You mean the president? You want to speak to the president?
If he's the leader of the South.
Mm-hmm.
The South. But let me get this straight. Where you're from, everything is South, right? So you want to speak to every president, every single one. You're screwed.
No, he's not. No, he's not screwed. Sancho, you're missing the one crucial piece of this jigsaw puzzle.
Really?
Yeah.
What?
Me.
You're screwed.
Play chess?
No.
Mr. Sweet does. He's like the best player in New York. He makes a pretty good living hustling college kids and tourists. He's helped me out a lot in the past. Do you sleep okay?
I adapt.
Yeah. You gotta adapt. Like water. You put water in a glass, it becomes a glass. You put it in a bottle, it becomes a bottle. You put water in a teapot, it becomes a teapot. Be water, my friend. Bruce said that.
He was wise.
Lily! Lily, it's out.
He's kind of mad. Hi.
Tyler.
Hey, Theo. Wasn't too happy to hear Chloe was picking up strays again.
What state you from?
Nunavut.
Language?
Inuktitut.
Ever see a penguin?
Only in books.
Ever built an igloo?
Yes, many.
Yep. He's an Eskimo, all right.
Inuk.
In your what? Oh, I wasn't signifying. I was testing you. That was a test. And you passed. That is one crazy story. But I don't buy that end of the world nonsense.
Look at him.
Oh, I've been looking, and it looks like he's telling the truth.
It may not end. Ooh. It may simply change.
Mm-hmm.
But we will all suffer.
Suffer? Have you seen where we're sitting?
It's time for a revolution.
No, it ain't. Okay. So. We in the South is doing some real bad stuff. And the sun got hit and it's coming down the bus head. Now some dead dude is dreaming all this, leading your people to send you here to warn the president.
Every president.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Every president. Why New York?
I don't understand.
Why are you here in New York?
They gave me a ticket.
Oh.
They didn't explain.
You didn't ask?
No.
Why not London, or Paris, or Tokyo?
If I need to be somewhere else, I will go.
How, brother? How? You got some wings I don't know about?
I have legs.
You can't be walking to Europe, huh? Ain't you never seen a map? Where you going now?
Away.
Ain't you been listening to me? You need a plan.
No.
No.
What will be, will be.
Oh, come on. What am I doing here? What will be, will be. Who do you think you are? Some divine and glorious Buddha? And I'm taking you serious. I tell you what, why don't you stay here and Mr. Sweet will split? Because I'm a busy man. I got things to do, and you need to stop picking up strays.
Thank you.
What a shame.
Hey, why are you so interested in this guy?
Chloe. Chloe.
What I see in this guy? I see innocence. And purpose. And meaning. I haven't believed in anything for way too long. Been living here the whole time?
Been here one time.
Once? How the hell did you find your way back here from Harlem?
Inukshuks. On the tundra, there are no landmarks, so we built them. Here, there are many. I don't need to build any.
Why are you so down? Mr. Sweet's a smart guy, but he ain't always right.
This time he is. I don't know anything about this place.
That's what you're worried about? Right here, it's everything you need to know about America. It's a standard form of education. Schools are just used for socializing.
For unbelievable riches.
The prize is the largest in television history. Over $10 million. The stakes? Are everything you've got.
I gotta go.
Bring the others. There's plenty of room here. Teach me. I needed to learn more about my new environment, New York. I have to absorb my surroundings and the people. When I was a boy, we were taught that we are stronger as a group. For example, I cannot harvest a walrus all by myself. I must have help. Even with all this information, the Southerners have so much to learn. So much is discarded. But by using our resources, we can find our place. What I am realizing is that when you are in an unfamiliar place, you must establish community by reaching out, connecting with nature, communicating with the people of the village, and finally, you can adapt. This way, you can find people who believe. I've been entrusted by my elders to deliver an important message, and I cannot do this alone.
A lot of people starting to listen to your boy. You think he's good for his cause? A bunch of bums getting behind him?
It ain't a cause.
It's a quest.
Tell him I know why they sent him to New York.
Why?
Just tell him. Checkmate. That's $50, kid. Double or nothing.
Isn't this the one area us girls have never found a solution for? Well, now we have. With the shake weights. Now we can shake our way to firm and fabulous arms and shoulders in just 6 minutes a day. It works your triceps.
I need to walk. When I think about this place, it's so easy to get lost, to lose your way. The people of the South seem to be trying to find themselves, find their grounding. It's like they're being pulled away from their center. They have every convenience in the world, but they do not know what it is like to walk under the big sky. So I must learn to live in their world, in the shadow of the skyscrapers.
Wow, an Eskimo.
He's an Inuk.
What are you doing here?
I'm listening.
Wow.
He's here to save the world. The sun.
Why don't you guys sit down and tell us about it?
If you really think about it, the environment is a school, but without walls. We must be open to everything it is teaching us. It really is a giver of life, and we must protect it. Because things are changing way too fast.
New York. You were sent here for a reason.
He's gonna save the
easy,
world.
Easy, Tyler. No. I said here. Now, why was he sent here if he needed to speak to all the leaders of the world, huh?
That's a good question.
Why? Mr. Inuk, meet Mr. United Nations.
I'd already worked that out, but coming from Sweet, it sounded better.
Yeah, but you still need a plan.
And a suit.
She's right. You're gonna need a suit. You can't go into that joint looking like a friggin' Eskimo. You gotta look cool, else they think you're crazy. Though I'm guessing they're gonna think that anyway as soon as you open your mouth.
Yeah, people think I'm crazy.
We'll go shopping tomorrow.
Okay, I'm out of here. I gotta go before they close the shelter.
You're welcome to stay here if you want to.
What? And lose my bed? What'll happen when you're not around anymore? Uh-uh. But I'll be thinking.
We're close, huh?
Yes.
I guess you'll be heading back after? You miss it?
Yes. The silence, the simplicity.
Simplicity is the key to brilliance. Bruce.
What about you? Do you miss your home?
This is my home. Nothing to miss.
What about your family?
My dad. But these guys are my family now.
I'm
been on the streets so long, I can barely remember why I ran away in the first place. I was a junkie and a thief. Until a couple years ago, that's when Mr. Sweet found me. Anyway, I chose to run. And I'm not saying that this is the sweet life, but it was my choice. I can live with that.
Life is so full of difficulties, but in my homeland, our sense of family binds us together like a warm coat against a cold wind. We were taught that to waste resources is a form of stealing, and we should never overharvest. I have observed that in New York, overharvesting has a special name. It's called yapping.
Would you like change?
How much you got?
No.
We want a suit.
A suit. Okay. Am I being filmed?
What?
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 We just want a suit, please.
Yes, I heard that, but...
But what, Tinkerbell? We want a freaking suit! You need me to slap the wax out of your ears?
You want to try it, sister?
I chose to let that comment slide. To be the bigger person in this situation. Dun, 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 dun. We decided on somewhere a little more reasonable.
Okay, let's shop. Presenting Theo. Don't he look fly?
He looks so good.
I just super fly. You got the suit. I got the plan. All these degenerates you've been talking to around town, I think they just might come in handy.
Got your back. Don't take no for an answer, and keep your eyes peeled.
You're not coming in with me?
I think one freak at a time is all they can handle. Come here.
You can do this, Theo. Just be you.
Good luck.
All right.
Sorry.
Thank you.
one?
Your first name.
My first name. The day I was born in a NICU, my mother gave me a name, naming me after her mother, Puya.
Why were you at the UN?
Because I was on a mission.
You realize that just barging into the UN is illegal?
No.
Well, you know, you call the king the king, you call the queen the queen, you call Mr. Sweet.
Mr. Sweet.
Mr. Sweet?
Mr. Sweet.
Yes, sir.
What is your given name?
Tyler.
You're in trouble.
Why were you at the UN? What is her relation to you?
What's her name?
Her name is Chloe.
Chloe's not violent.
I didn't mean to break the law, but your stupid guards got in my way.
We were trying to get in to talk to the elders, but for some reason they wouldn't let us in.
Who are the people that you show up to the UN with? Who are these people?
They're my friends. They're my tribe. They're my nation.
The sun is going to create chaos in the world. We have angered the sun.
So your message is based on some type of anger. And you're being sent by a group of people to the UN. You were going there to hurt someone. This, let me tell you what I think. You were going there to hurt someone. You understand what's going on here. I want to know why you and the rest of your party decided to go into the UN unauthorized. You have serious problems. Why are you here? That's what I need to know.
Listen,
I am not playing games. You are in serious
trouble. I came to deliver a message from the Inuit people. Are you listening?
I screwed everything up. Like I always do.
Hey, yo! How's the Eskimo, man?
Hey. Did you talk with the police?
Yes, my lawyers did. Are you all right?
I have some friends still in there.
I know. And I'm not sure what I can do for them because we have to see what they're charged with. But the young girl, she might be in a little trouble. Can we go someplace and talk? You know, I heard your story about the son. I was listening at the UN. And I found it fascinating.
I was sent here to deliver a message.
But
the message I should be delivering is to my own people.
What is the message?
We are too late. Your leaders don't have the power to change anything. Your television sets have the real power. They compel you to buy things that you do not need and envy things that are worthless. They tell you to drive cars that cannot even move because everyone else is driving one in cities where there's no clean air. They mock the way you look and affect your happiness. What can your leaders do about your nature when it is so corrupted that when you live each day, it's based on consuming, devouring, and wasting, never happy until nothing is left? My message should be for my own people. We must prepare for the sun's kiss, for it is surely coming sooner than we think.
Theo! Wait, if you would agree to say exactly what you just said in front of an audience, I swear that I will do everything in my power to get your friends out of jail. Look, here's my card. If you agree, that's my address.
what happened today.
Are you pleased?
No. So what next?
I have Chloe's pictures. Should
no,
I
that's not what I'm talking about. No, I mean, what are you gonna do?
I feel I should go home.
Really? Go home? No. That's not an option. You're the one that got their hearts into this. I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I mean, all right. Look around you. This is what we got. It's never gonna get any better than this. Well, you come into our lives, it's different. Everything changes. For a minute, they get to feel like there was somebody. They're not thinking about what they can't do, they're thinking about what they can. You inspired them. You need to fix this. You started it, you finish it. You understand me?
Good job.
So we talked almost all night. Monica wants to organize an event so the leaders of the South can hear my message. And I couldn't wait to share the good news with my friends.
Theo. Have as much as you'd like.
Check this out. Persian. About mid-18th century. From the look of it, it's got to weigh at least 60 pounds.
Well, I don't know how much it weighs, actually, but you're dead on about the country of origin and the age. How'd you know that?
I used to be in the rug business when I was younger.
Selling?
Stealing.
Ah, okay. Well, thanks for getting us out and all that, but we really gotta get going. Tyler!
But there's lots of room here. We will all be comfortable.
Well, do you mean that?
Oh, come on. We can't impose?
Yeah, no, we can't impose. Tyler, sweet.
It would make great use of all this wasted space. Is that not true?
Please, I insist. All of you, you must be my guests while I arrange for Theo to speak.
What?
Juicy.
But who was this person? I mean, who lets four homeless people just move into their house?
No. A night moves like this. In an L shape, and he can jump other pieces.
Okay.
No,
a queen don't jump.
She moves like this.
What about the king?
A king is a lazy fool.
He don't get nowhere fast. This is a rook, or a castle. It moves up and down. Side to side.
But castles don't move.
Are you messing with me?
Hey, want to take a seat?
Why?
I could show you how to use this thing. You can make yourself useful around here. Oh, come on. It's fun. So,
What we're trying to do here is we're looking for companies that want to sponsor an event that Theo would speak at. All right, so what you do is you go to this little box over here with the cursor, type in, say, Green Companies, and then you get a whole list. And you just click on one of them with the tracking pad, and that's how you find a list of potential sponsors. Do you think you'd do that for me? You don't like me very much, do you, Chloe?
What's there to like? Your money? Your house?
So you think you're the only one who's had it tough? Look, I don't know you. I don't know your story. I don't know what you've been through. And maybe it's been very dark for you. But living on the street does not automatically make you morally superior, Sugar.
Yeah, castles don't move. Once you build it, if the cornerstone is fixed properly, solid foundation. It's not going anywhere.
Look, man, I know the physics. And I'm saying it don't matter, because it's a game.
But it has no purpose.
Of course it has a purpose. It's a game, it's purpose, it's fun. And fun is what we have right now. This is fun.
I don't like fun.
Chloe, please open the door.
Go away, Monica.
I think you should come out here so we can talk about this.
If I come out there, I won't be responsible for my actions.
I am prepared to take that chance if you are.
Seriously?
Yes. You don't trust me, right?
No, I don't.
All right, I understand that. But what can I do?
You can start by telling me why you're helping him.
Helping Theo?
Yeah.
Why do people always want simple answers? Her name is Baruti. She was 18 months old in South Africa when that picture was taken. Look at those bright eyes. When Baruti was 2 years old, she developed full-blown AIDS. She was one of my patients, and our treatment could have saved her. But in the real world, things aren't that simple. See, children are excluded from clinical trials because it's considered child abuse to expose them to experimental treatments. The powers that be have their agendas, and so instead of saving this beautiful girl's life, I sat by her bedside every day and watched as the light went out of those little eyes. Just as I'd sat and watched countless others die, people I could have saved, but I didn't because the rules said I couldn't. So, after Baruti, I made myself a pact. No more rules. If I could help, I would. There's so much indifference in this world that I can barely sleep at night. And if I can make one tiny difference in something, I have to. That's the least I can do, right?
Check.
Hey! to visit it to school, and my elders had noticed that I could speak their language a bit, so they sent me here. And you know, in there, it was a missionary-run school, so therefore, religion was one. Probably the first thing that they taught us. I learned about God, and in the beginning was the earth, which is a gift. We have a responsibility to look after what we have been given, but far too often, the inhabitants are taking and not giving back. So I was chosen by my elders to bring this message to the people of the South and their leaders.
Okay, everybody, it's time to go.
Great. It all sounded promising. Monica set up a meeting with people who might support an event for Theo to deliver his message.
Okay, good. Come on, then. Come on, guys.
All right, guys. Remember, this is really important, okay? Let's just let Theo do all the talking, all right? Come on. Come on in.
Are there no stairs?
Yes, but we have to take the elevator.
I'll take the stairs.
Don't be silly. It's on the 62nd floor.
Stairs.
Is there a problem with the elevator? Because he's doing his part to reduce his carbon footprint.
There you go.
Good for him.
You do realize, Monica, that the reason that we have been waiting here for you is because we would like to meet this Mr. Theo? Yes, I completely understand, and I truly apologize for the delay. I was not aware that he had an issue with that sort of mechanical conveyance, but he is an amazing person and fully worth the wait, I promise you all. Look, at the end of the day, your individual companies have made great contributions to the world. But all of you sitting at this table right now, if you join forces and help us elevate Theo to a place where he can spread his message with his voice, you all have the chance to save
the... That's not enough. I'm sure Theo's a great guy, but I have another meeting I have.
Sit yourself down, lady.
Excuse me?
We came a long way to talk to you guys. And right now, the little guy's struggling up 62 flights of stairs to talk to you.
Look, this has gotten really uncomfortable and very unprofessional.
I'm sorry, she shouldn't have spoken
to
you like that.
No need to be sorry. Chloe's right. You've got the money, we all know that, but do you have the heart? See, you gotta understand one thing. You are not the only game in this town. You think you're checking us out? Every player in this city wants a piece of us. But the question is, do we want a piece of you? Okay? Now, I don't mean any offense.
And nor do I. But waiting for him to walk up 62 flights
of stairs.
Okay, all
right, okay. Just give me 2 minutes. 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Monica, can I have your computer?
Come on, Chloe.
You see, the ice my people depend on to survive is vanishing. It might seem insignificant to you, but if I don't bring you this message, our way of life will be gone. Here in the South, you have not seen these changes, but you will. Our forefathers were wise and taught us well, but the day will come when we ourselves will be forefathers. Are we being wise? My people ask you to act, or it will be too late.
a long walk.
Oh, Theo. Meeting's over. Yeah, they all waited like half an hour for you. Lucky for you, your friends were there. Because they're gonna back us! It was an indescribable feeling. After everything we'd been through, Theo's message was going to be heard by people who can actually do something.
Oh, box.
Not just a box.
Oh, okay.
There's something in it.
Whoa. Take a look at this, guys.
You like them?
Yes, I do. Just like walking on clouds.
We won't mention the sweatshops then.
Sorry?
No, what? Never mind. They're so cool.
Makes me even taller.
Theo, come on, boy. Don't hurt me. Yeah. Mama told me there'd be days like this.
You know, sometimes Theo just needed to walk, to be under the sky. He helped me see the beauty in the smallest things, to see the good in everyone. But it's hard to see the good in what happened next. There are days when I feel responsible, and my heart aches. Because if I had known what would happen to him, I never would have let him out of my sight.
Thank you.
something stupid and pointless. Something wasteful, as Theo would have said.
Once you know the story, how this little Inuit guy
thought he could change the course of history. And it wasn't because he wanted to be rich or famous. It was just because he wanted the world to stay beautiful. Because he wanted to keep being an Inuit guy living an Inuit life like his pa and his grandpa. He just didn't know he could do it.
You know, I asked Theo about his homeland one night, and I'll never forget what he said.
It is unlike anything you've ever seen. The snow, the stillness. It chases you and never lets you go. In this moment, you realize that you are standing on sacred ground. Underneath you are cathedrals of ice, home to life we will never see. What song are they singing? What story are they telling? Will we care for them? Will we care for each other? This is my hope. This is my prayer.
If there's a heaven like they say there is, and it's all beautiful and white, then maybe he's home. Hunting and fishing and walking friggin' everywhere. I know one thing, though. It's time for a revolution. A revolution of the mind.
Well, I must say you made quite an impact with this story.
And I'm sure the people at home will be thinking a little more about what it was that Theo said, let me get it right,
caring for one another.
Now, if you don't mind my saying it, you yourself, you've come a long way.
I got a lot of people who I love and who love me. And I'm tired of running. This is the sweet life. And I have the rest of mine to look forward to.
Have any last words for our viewers?
Don't think. Feel. It's like a finger pointing to the moon. Don't concentrate on the finger, or you'll miss all the heavenly glory.
That was a profound statement.
That was Bruce Lee.
Those things, some days you got it, but hate, oh hate, it's only here because somebody taught it. See, how can we learn the lesson of love if we choose to hide in the dark? Shine. So everybody can shine too. Open your heart and lead the way. You don't have to be afraid. It's in you. You to rise high above your greatest fears. And with a little bit of light, you can make it brighter here. Oh, so everybody shine, shine on, everybody shine, shine on, everybody shine. grace. We could use a little grace, sisters and brothers. Shame, oh what a shame that we do not give in to one another. See, how can we learn the lesson of love if we choose to hide in the dark? Shine so everybody can shine too. Open your heart and lead the way. You don't have to be afraid, it's in you. You to rise high above your greatest fears. And with a little bit of light, you can make it brighter here. Oh, so everybody shine, shine on, shine on. Everybody shine, shine on, shine on. Everybody shine. Now how can we learn the lesson of love if we choose to hide in the dark? Shine so everybody can shine too. Open your heart and lead the way. You don't have to be afraid, it's in you. In you to rise high above your greatest fears. And with a little bit of light, you can make it brighter here. Everybody shine.
Thank you. Kjörkin far.